the phosphate is going to be there, and because of the consumption of the phosphate, the biological phosphate removal is going to be there. So with the help of microorganism, just with the help of activated sludge, whatever the area is there, we have to just partition, we have to carry just partition of that area into two. One is anaerobic area and another is aerobic area. We have to grow an aerobic organism in anaerobic area, so they are not going to grow, and then we have to shift them to the aerobic area. So when they are shifted to the aerobic area, they will grow as fast as possible and they will consume more and more phosphate, whatever present in the wastewater, and by that we have to go for the collection of the microorganism. So as and when the microorganisms are collected, 90% of the phosphate removal can be possible by the biological phosphate removal processes. So that is one of the best way to remove the phosphate from the wastewater. And then the process is there, the step is there, that is known as post aeration. So advanced treatment is there that have the removal of suspended solids, the activated carbon treatment, chlorination, nitrogen removal, phosphorus removal or phosphate removal. After this, whatever the dissolved oxygen is there, if that is going to be depleted, we have to go for the increase of the DO, and for that the method is there, that is known as post aeration. So primary and secondary, even advanced treatment reduces the dissolved oxygen from the sewage, and thus to maintain it, post aeration is carried out. It can be accomplished by mechanical rotors and even by cascading slow technique. The next one. The picture shows the post aeration. The pond is there with the water that is passed from the advanced treatment, and now whatever the DO maintenance is there, that is going to be there in this particular effluent, and now this effluent is ready to landfill or land application or for the disposal. So next please. So now the disposal is there. So after all this treatment, the effluent is disposed out in various ways. The disposal into the surface water, the land application and landfill can be there. Maybe there are the variety of the lakes are there in many of the cities. They have the effluent of the wastewater that is treated by the advanced treatment, that is treated by the secondary treatment, and from that the lakes are prepared. So lake preparation or pond preparation inside the city, there are many of the cities in the India are also there. They contain in the center of the city the particular lake, and that lake is full of this type of the water. That water is treated after the secondary treatment or after the advanced treatment. So now this is the case about the effluent. So next one. Now we have the sludge with us after the completion of secondary treatment and advanced treatment. Now what is there? After the wastewater treatment, primary, secondary and advanced treatment, one of the very most important step is known as solid processing, the sludge. We have already discussed the sludge, what is sludge, all the thing we know very well. The important step is there, that is known as thickening of the sludge. This can be possible by gravity thickening. What exactly the gravity thickening? In which the water content is there, that is going to be removed from the sludge, and the mass of the sludge is prepared in such a way that is ready to use for anaerobic sludge digestion, and that is very important process, that is biological process in which the thermophilic organisms are used. Dewatering of sludge is there and disposal of sludge is there. Finally, whatever sludge is prepared that we can used as a compost, that we have to discuss later on, but right now we have to concentrate on what exactly the anaerobic sludge digestion. So in the solid processing, the most important process or most important step is anaerobic sludge digestion. The word is anaerobic, so here no involvement of the oxygen is there. So bacteria, they are involved in this method, are known as anaerobic organism. The sludge, we know very well what is sludge, and digestion. The word digestion is there because microorganisms involved in this step, they are utilizing in condition that is anaerobic, and they are responsible for the digestion of organic matter. So anaerobic digestion is a series of process in which microorganisms break down biodegradable material in the absence of oxygen, used for industrial or domestic purposes to manage the waste or to release the energy. So that is their metabolic process by which they are digesting the particular biodegradable material. Next one. anaerobic sludge digestion, there are four key biological and chemical stage of anaerobic digestion. And now we have to concentrate on this four stages. That four steps that are very most important step are hydrolysis, acidogenesis, acetogenesis and methanogenesis. The first is hydrolysis. What exactly the hydrolysis? We know very well H2O breakdown is that 2H plus and oxygen is released. The same step is there. Why that is significant? Because we know about the sludge. The sludge contain heavy amount of the water, and that water removal, the thickening of the sludge is there by this particular step, that is we call it as hydrolysis. So first step, that is very most important step in anaerobic sludge digestion, that is hydrolysis. And by that the thickening is going to be there, that is one of the metabolic process of anaerobic bacteria, thermophilic bacteria, they are involved in anaerobic sludge digestion. The second step involved is acidogenesis. Acidogenesis, what is acidogenesis? Acid production. Now what is acid production? Acid production is the one when organism utilizes organic matter, and we call it that matter is, or what we call it that particular thing, we call it fermentation. What is fermentation? Where electric organic donor and organic acceptor, electron donor and electron acceptor, both are organic one. That phenomena is known as fermentation. So many of the book even represents acidogenesis as fermentation. With the help of fermentation or with the help of acidogenesis, many of the organic matter that is present in the biodegradable waste that is going to decompose by the variety of thermophilic bacteria, variety of anaerobic bacteria. So that is second very most important step being processed by the organism. The third step is acetogenesis. Acetogenesis just have the role of acetone group. And the fourth most important is methanogenesis, or the production of methane gas, that we can see from the next figure. In the figure, you can see the particular anaerobic sludge digester. Now, this is the single stage is there. The one digester is there, but now there are double chambered anaerobic digesters are even available. This particular figure you can just see in the central area, active digestion is there. The sludge is going to be collected from the base and the gas is collected from the topmost area. Even we can discuss this. This is the schematic diagram, but better explanation is there from the next figure. You can just see in this particular figure at the base mixing zone is there. Whatever the sludge is added, the solid part is added, that is there in the center area. The sludge zone is there. In this sludge zone, the thermophilic organism and anaerobic organism grow in such a way, acidogenesis, acetogenesis, hydrolysis occurs. Whatever the liquid is there, that is going to be less and less, and the sludge is prepared, the thickening is there, and even that degradation is there in such a way, the methane gas is liberated, and the yellow portion at the topmost shows the biogas collection. So this is the anaerobic sludge digester with the thick wall is there. Here temperature, pH, all the thing is very much significant. And this now even this is there with the doubled chamber. So this is single chamber is there. Now even the double chambered anaerobic sludge digester are there with many of the wastewater treatment plant. Next please. Now we are coming to the last point, that is composting. What exactly the compost? After the anaerobic sludge digestion, after the treatment of solid, whatever we have with us that is passed from the ultrafiltration, that is passed from the heat treatment, that is passed from the vacuum filtration and the vacuum, whatever the collection is there, because of that the thick portion is there. The thick particles are there, that is rich in the organic matter, that is rich with the nutrient, and that we call it as compost. Now what is compost? Compost is soil conditioner. We know about the conditioner. There are variety of the conditioners are there. Soil conditioner is there, that we call it as compost. And that compost we can obtain from the wastewater treatment by the processing of the solid and by the anaerobic sludge digestion. So what is compost? Compost can be rich in nutrient. It is used in garden, landscaping, horticulture and agriculture. The compost itself is beneficial and in also applied in the land as a soil conditioner as well as for as a fertilizer. So that is about the compost that we obtained by the solid processing. Next, please. So this is overall summary of the wastewater treatment. First of all, what we have discussed in the whole wastewater treatment, we have discussed about the primary treatment, the secondary treatment, advanced treatment, and then the solid processing. There are four basic steps. What exactly the first step is? The first step is primary treatment, where the coarse part are going to be removed. And in the secondary treatment, the role of aerobic as well as anaerobic is there. Aerobic, it means whatever the process is that is being carried out in aerobic condition with the help of oxygen, while anaerobic is the one where no involvement of the organism is there, no involvement of anaerobic bacteria is there. So anaerobic and aerobic processes are there. We have discussed about the secondary treatment in which oxidation pond, force derivation are involved. Then we have discussed about the advanced treatment. In the advanced treatment, we have discussed chlorination, activated carbon, and whatever the effluent is there that we can go, we can apply it for the landfill, we can apply it for the waterways in the lake also, that can be applied, and whatever the solid is left that is applied for anaerobic sludge digestion, and compost can be prepared and that act as the solid conditioner. But all this thing is based on which type of the wastewater is there, how much volume of the wastewater is there, how many type of the toxic product is there in wastewater, and according to that we have to proceed for the process. We have to even consider in this particular method the unit that we are establishing as the wastewater treatment plant, which type of the instruments are available, which type of the area is available, and on that basis we can proceed for the treatment. So that is all about the wastewater treatment. I think any other thing you can say?
So friends, we can conclude that wastewater treatment is economically important, ethically important, legally important, and socially important. How it is important economically? So we know that as ma'am has already discussed in their talk, that we can get biogas or methane via this process. So we are facing the scarcity of fuel nowadays, particularly petroleum fuel and all the things. In this condition, biogas may be the one of the best option for alternate fuel source. Methane, which is generated from this process, it can also use to generate electricity, and even some examples are also there at where entire plant's electricity is running from methane, which is which has been generated from their own plant. So we can reduce our own electric bill of wastewater treatment plant. So this is economic aspect. Even madam has already told that some lakes or ponds can also be created in which this water can be discharged at last. So some recreational activities can also be carried out, means some amusement park or some garden or many other things can be prepared in such case places from at the end of wastewater treatment. So in this way we can say that it is economically important process. It is important ethically also, because it is our moral duty that we should not discharge such polluted water or such wastewater in any natural water body directly. Otherwise it may harass or it may make an imbalance in natural or in aquatic ecosystem, and certain organisms may be extinct out due to our such activities. So it is our moral duty, or it is our ethical duty also to do this treatment. It is legally also, because there are so many environmental protection acts are also running, like GPCB, like government bodies are also running, like Gujarat Pollution Control Board or CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board. They are also looking after to such, they are also encouraging such activities for wastewater. So at last we can conclude that it is our economic, moral, social, legal, ethical, all this our duty that water must be treated before discharging in any wastewater. So friends, this is very important question. Almost some of the questions are compulsorily asked in exams from this part. It may be in full length question, it may be in some short notes, or it may be some objective questions may also be asked in the exam. So from exam point of view, it is also economic to earn some good marks in exam. So now if you have any doubts or queries, then you can ask.